Hi, my name is Roger. This is the last video where we're going to deal with all the file operations. This here is the save as, the save function. This part of the code, let me highlight it for you. This here is exactly the same as with the previous video up here. It's exactly the same code. So you can copy and paste that one in if you want to. This here, this first line here, is the one that's probably most important. F is a folder item, is get folder item, path SRT file. Where this one came from, it's a string variable, as you remember. Load SRT file, that's where that one gets populated over here. We're going to put in there native path, so the complete path to the opened SRT file, and then you can override it. Let me get that button first. The save button of our menu had this code behind it. Now, if that particular variable is empty, then we're going to show the save as dialog. But if it's not empty, well, we can simply override the existing file. That's basically what you do here. What's the result of all of this code? Well, basically this. I believe I showed you before, but I'm going to do it one more time. This is the bad example, and I don't want to overwrite this one, so I'm going to use the save as dialog. It has the same code behind it, as you know. So I'm going to call this one test2, and I'm going to reset the program. Now I'm going to read in this text, test2, and as you see, it reads it like this. This is how the file is written at this moment. So it reads it even faster in this list box because it's a nice structure. All of the file is like that, as you can see. As you can see, it simply is written like this. So that's what this code actually creates for you as a subtitle file. Very nice structure. In the next video, we will start with all the time. And of course, we're going to start with the push buttons. Let me show you, because all those push buttons also have code behind it. And that's where we're going to start in the next video.